In this edition of Candlestick School, we're going to be looking at the hammer pattern. Stay tuned. Hey traders and investors, a very warm welcome to you. Okay, so candlesticks, very, very important, very, very useful in the right conditions. This one, we are going to talk about the hammer pattern. Okay, the candlestick pattern that is called the hammer is a very, very powerful one. Let's look at what it's all about, when we can use it, time frame, setup, stops, risks, all that kind of stuff. Risk, should I say, all that kind of stuff, which is what we need to make the best trades possible. Okay, so candles, I'm going to show you some examples on the chart in a second. I'm just going to freehand draw you on love my freehand kind of stuff. Basically, a hammer is that. There's your tail of your candle there, and you've got a short body here. Now, people will say, or textbooks will say, it can be a green, it can be a red candle. Fine, if that's the textbook example and that's the textbook kind of definition of it, that's fine by me. However, I prefer to see this candlestick pattern, this hammer pattern, at lows with a green body. Let me explain why. At lows, because we have this wick, so we have this kind of change in sentiment that occurs intraday or in the middle of the time frame, depending on what we're doing. We'll talk about time frames in a second, where it works best on. But we have that change in sentiment, and we have a close generally at the high. If we've got a solid green, then this is going to be our close, this is going to be our open, this is going to be our low, and the close is going to be close to the high. So for me, that shows that the pressure is still there right until that bell. Well, of course, if we're trading Forex, it's going to be the evening session. But the point is, it's the steady pressure that has changed intraday and finished at an extreme. That is the key thing for me. Now, of course, if you want to use it with the red body, fine. If you want to use it in different conditions, fine. But I'm just giving you what I feel is the best way of using this. And ultimately, guys, if we can narrow our focus right down and only look for it in the best situations, that's we're going to get the best results. Okay, so that's our hammer pattern. And there's a nice example here on crude oil. But before I get to that, let me talk about time frames. Daily, perfect. Weekly, perfect. Monthly, perfect. For all you swing traders out there, that is a great time to trade it. It is showing you, especially on a daily chart, it's showing you that intraday change in sentiment. If you are want to go down a little bit kind of smaller on your time frames, 60 I think is good. Your 4 hourly is good. You're starting to push your luck a little bit on your 15, your 5, and your 1. But let me just add a caveat to that. If you are in really extreme market conditions, let's say, well, not necessarily stupidly extreme, but good, fast market conditions, you're looking at your 5-minute candlestick chart, you get that drive lower, you get the hammer pattern after a strong drive lower, then I think you're good to go. The point is you have to be more strict with when the candlestick pattern occurs. We'll talk about that in a second in terms of when the best time to use it is. But you have to kind of be much more strict with your filter in that the lower time frame you go. The higher time frames, you can be less strict with the market conditions and it still become effective. Hope that makes sense. Right, okay, so daily chart, very, very powerful. 60-minute chart, very, very powerful as well. And if you want to go kind of really high up your time frames, you're going to be good on your weeklies, your monthlies. So the idea of this is that we're looking for that change in sentiment. The theory behind this pattern is, hey, when we see it, we go long. It's a bullish pattern. I prefer to see it at lows. I think that's a better place to see it. I prefer to see a green body. Okay, what else do I prefer to see? I would be very cautious taking it in an aggressive trending environment. If you look at this crude oil example here, okay, let's just clear off my lovely freehand drawing. This is the one I'm looking at. I'm not going to kind of cover it too much with a pen, but you can see what I'm looking at here. It's this specific candle here, the one I'm highlighting there, this green one. I'm zooming a little bit more so we can see what's going on. The conditions behind this. Now, this is a winning one. I'm going to go look at some other losing ones in a second because I think it's very important to cover all bases. Great for winners, great for losers. Let's see how we can manage the risk. There's no point having a great setup that every time it loses 10 times your winners. We don't want that. All right, so there's our candlestick pattern, the one that I'm highlighting here with my cursor now. You see I've got a good green body, got a decent kind of length on the tail. Intraday change in sentiment. Didn't quite close at high, did we? But it's close enough. And the body is okay. Maybe prefer a little bit tighter body to show a bit of a more of an extreme to lows. But it doesn't matter. The kind of fundamental supply demand that we can deduce from that candlestick pattern is there. So we've got that there. We've got that change in sentiment. Great. Now, what I wanted to point out, guys, and I've got a couple of examples for you, is this kind of wave pattern that we see on this crude oil chart. This, to me, is very important. Let me get my freehand brush out. This is so, so important, guys. If we're taking this kind of pattern, be very cautious. We're in a very steep trend right at lows, because the supply demand is so aggressive in one way on the higher time frame on that trend, whether that's kind of 10, 15 days, 20 days, 30 days on a daily, or however many candles it may be, it's so aggressive that you're really pushing your luck thinking you're going to find the bottom on that. Now, obviously, the higher the, if it's a really broad cam hammer, maybe it's got a catalyst with some news, go for it. But this is what I like to see. I like to see this rotational type trade. In other words, it's a battle. Bulls have had some control. This crude oil here, bulls have had some control from 47 up to 54. Bears have had some control. It's been a nice two-way trade over the couple of month period, over the quarter, whatever it may be. And then you see the hammer. So you see kind of things that suggest, hey, we're not just looking for the hammer as an indicator. We know that there are some buyers out there because we've seen this rotational two-way trade. It's come down a bit, it's come up, it didn't take the highs. Bears are slightly in control, of course. We're taking out lows, we're not going to fresh highs. But it means that if you get on the end of it, there's a decent swing there for you. And that's the key thing to look for with this, I believe. Okay, so let's go rules. So rules, generally, pretty simple, guys. If we're going to take it textbook style, our stop is always going to be below this low. Now, that may seem a little bit wide, and sometimes you're going to get a wider stop. If you want to drill it down a little bit and kind of go for two-thirds or something, that's fine by me. I think that's okay. I think always be on the more cautious side. So if you can go wider with your stop, better to go wider. You want to have it just under that low. You want to kind of have it, you know, however much that range is, maybe add another 10% or whatever under that low. So that's your hard stop point. To be honest, it shouldn't be going anywhere near that. The whole point is you're looking for the supply demand imbalance. And if you're extra aggressive, I would suggest you could even use it kind of halfway in the candle or the close, or the open, or some other level if you want to be ultra, ultra tight about it. But, you know, textbook style, you want to give it some room. Your entry is going to be either two ways. You've got one on the close of the candle, so that's going to be there where my cursor is, or you're going to take it the next day when it breaks out on the high. So in this example, I can zoom in a little bit more for us. In this example, it's pretty close, right? There's your entry. Entry's going to be 46.66, or it's going to be whatever that close was there, 46.46 approximately, give or take a few cents, depending on what exactly it was and when exactly you get in and your slippage and spread, etc. So there's your entry. Your stop is going to be there. Now, targets, it's going to depend on the conditions you're in. You know, if you're in nice rotational conditions, for example, with this one, I might say to myself, okay, what was the distance between that and that? Can I use that as a kind of framework to see where we could go? What's a key level? I'm just eyeballing this, or $50 is a key level. Maybe I want to be a bit more cautious on that. Do I want a three-day move? Do I want to trail it? Do I want to kind of stick a moving average under and trail it? Let's see what we got here. That's a bit wide, isn't it? Is that loading? You know, that kind of moving average, perhaps if it breaks that, I could use that and close on that. You get the idea, guys. This is not a trailing stop or a stop exit kind of video, but the point is to get you in and give you that head start so that then you can say, okay, well, actually, you know what? I think crude oil's bottoming here for a multi-month move, or I think crude oil is just stretched and we're going to ping back. The spring is going to retrace. So I'm going to take a three-day retracement, scalp it, get out, take my money and run. You know, that's the kind of thing you want to assess yourself as a trader. So there's the hammer. Another couple of examples for you guys I've got are, we've got the entry, done the exit, on the rules. Let's have a look at the another example here I've got on the pound. We've got a 60-minute chart here on the pound. Actually, before I go back, I've got some more on crude oil, some losers. I said I would do some losers because I think it's so, so important to include those. And I would encourage you to do the same, guys. If you're going back and you're looking at charts and you're kind of assessing whether you want to get involved in something, then by all means, you know, make sure that you're including some losers on there. I think I might have deleted it off. Maybe it's on the pound. Here we go. Okay, so we're on the pound. Let's zoom back. This is a beautiful one. This is a different time frame, guys. It's a 60-minute time frame. But again, like I said, I think we're still good to go on a 60-minute. Not a 60-minute. This is a 240-minute. This is a 4-hourly time frame. We're still good to go on this because it's a longer time frame. There's a supply demand shift in the middle of it. Here's one here, we're going long. As we kind of see this candle, it's got a nice shape to it. It's taken out some lows as well. That's another thing I did forget to mention. if we're taking out some lows with that wick, then pushing up, yeah, that's nice. That's really nice because it's closing above, it's faking out, sucking a few weak guys in, or taking out a few stops. Then it's pushing up. So in this one, you can see, you know, just don't need to kind of go into detail here. You can see this was a nice winner. However you traded it, this one here again, a nice winner. You're in an uptrend, and that's another thing to think. We're not just taking it on kind of big swings. We're also taking it in uptrend conditions when we kind of have a retracement. It may not be a deep retracement. Then we see that pattern there. And then we're all in on that, looking for the next leg. That's when it becomes most powerful as well. Where is the loser? Let me find it for you. There's a nice loser, and I say a nice loser. They're never nice, but they are part of the game. So here we are on crude oil, guys. This is this kind of thing that you would take all day, every day, and you get stopped on. But again, the point is that we want to manage the risk. It doesn't matter that we're getting stopped out. It matters that we are not getting hammered when we get it wrong, or just the wrong chart. So this is a nice setup. I'd have taken this all day, every day. Don't mind saying it. I'm not the kind of guy who says, I never take losers. I take losers and I embrace them, because that's how we get better. And you're never going to be able to stop them anyway. Nice uptrend here. Pulls back down to this level here. It's a textbook long. How we're looking on the higher time frame. Ooh, you know, that might caution you a little bit, the fact that we've had this brutal move down from a kind of 50% move down. But regardless of that, if you're just looking at this, and we never ever would just disregard this, but for kind of example purposes, let's do that and see how this loser would pan out. Comes down, it's sort of 50% retracement approximately of this move. It's a nice move from 42 to 60, very strong pullback. You're probably quite within your rights to say, you know what, it's pulling back and going to go long. I want to see a good signal. This is a little bit aggressive, this down move here. But again, regardless of that, let's consider we took it. Here's our nice hammer here. Push to lows, closed at highs, not far off highs, but it's good enough. I'd say that's a nice enough candle. I'd take it all day, every day. Your long is going to be either on the close, so there we're at 52.92, or above the high there on day three. Now, that's probably something that you might have reason not to take it. If you don't get the break on the second day, I'd be very careful, guys. For any of you taking up the close, good. If you want to take that break of the high, and you're on the third day, fourth day, or kind of fourth, fifth candle, depending on what time frame, I wouldn't take it. You want to see that continued momentum, aggression, bang, I'm in and it's flying. So that might be a warning sign, but let's say we took it anyway. What's our risk? You know, our risk isn't that much. We've got, relative to the reward we've got. Yes, okay, we can look at this and say, well, actually, your $3 is quite a lot of risk. But relative to the reward we've got, which of course is and a $6, $7, $8 if we're looking for a push back to highs. So it's not a bad risk reward ratio, and you can just see that by eyeballing it. We don't have to do the maths on it. There would be a long, you'd be stopped out probably as it came down here. Would you have come out earlier? Maybe you would have done. Would you have taken it? Maybe you wouldn't have done. But let's assume you did. The point is, it's not too much risk. It's worth taking these all day, every day. The risk reward ratio on most of them is pretty high, and if it's not, you don't take it. You want to see that there's genuine risk reward ratio here. And this is a kind of warning that we mentioned before, another loser here, but this is definitely one you wouldn't take because you're in this aggressive downtrend. There's been no buyers. The buyers have managed to push it up such a small amount that as soon as you do get this hammer shape, which is here, which is a very bullish candle, it's very nice, it's got the lows, taken out lows, pushed the highs, it's in the wrong kind of environment. It's too aggressive downtrend. You haven't seen that two-way trade, you haven't even seen a push and a retracement down, it's just literally a down move, and you're seeing at the bottom of down move. So be very cautious on those. If you want to take those, by all means, it's part of your trading plan, smaller size, and we're good to go. Other than that, guys, that's the hammer, powerful candlestick pattern. See you in the next one. Take care, bye-bye.